All of you, I hope you are doing well. So today we are going to learn the subject Internet Communication Engineering. Okay, so this is for the Electronics and Telecommunication branch for the semester 7. So now the first question arises, why we are learning this subject? Okay, so before starting any subject or creating the interest in that subject, first we know why we are learning these things. Okay, without knowing the things we are learning it, that is totally waste of time. So first I will tell you why we are learning this subject. Okay, so now what happened? Now in the subject name itself gives the meaning of the subject or why we are learning it. Okay, so Internet Communication Engineering, so internet itself gives the meaning of that. So now you are watching the video, right? So how now I am at the remote place, you are somewhere at your home, now you are watching this video, how it is possible? It is possible due to the internet, because I am sitting here right now and you are watching this video at your home. Now means this data is transferred to your mobile, or you can say that through the internet. Okay, so this is the communication between you and me through the internet. So how it happens? There is some transfer of data, right? So this how the data is transferred to you, how, which protocols which we can use while transferring this data, it is whole study we can going to study in that subject. That is nothing but Internet Communication Engineering. So internet means we can having the transfer of data, and communication means we are communicating with each other through this internet. So we are going to learn this through this subject. Now evolution of internet. So first topic we are going to learn, evolution of internet. So now we are using 4G, 5G. Okay, so now we are heading towards the 5G. Before that, right now we are using the 4G, right? So many service provider or network provider has given the our now 4G. Now BSNL is 3G. Now Jio is now the very reputed, we can say the very popular company that is giving the 4G. Okay, now in the few cities we are now heading towards the 5G also. Now you also have the difference, I think you are out of you, so many of you use the 2G also. Now there is a, you will get the difference between 2G, 3G and 4G. Okay, so there is a rate of the data transfer is faster in a upper versions. Okay, how it happens? Okay, so that is also one of the thing that we are going to learn in throughout the subject. Now evolution comes. Now before exactly what I want to say, when this internet has evolved means in the history, at the first time how the data is transferred and what was the speed of that data? Are you imagining in the 1970 or 1980 when the internet first, they have started the internet, then what is the speed of internet? Are you imagine that right now? Even in the 10 years ago, you are using the 2G. At that time, the 2G is also not having that much speed. Even for downloading the one image, you are required a lot of time. Okay, but right now, even on a one click, you can download a simple movie, or you can download the video of 200 and 300 MB. Right? So, how the evolution is happened in the internet? Because this is not happened overnight. There is a so many years, 30-40 years they have required to come to this stage. Okay, so we are going to start now the evolution of internet. Now you can see evolution of internet at the worldwide. I have shown here in the diagram, you can see like a evolution of a human. First we can be we can say the Neanderthal, and then we have developed the different stages. Okay, so right now you can see, so before that there is a very poor, we can say the transmission or internet rate. Now we can see after that we have come on the internet, that is on a PC. okay, so through the wired. Okay, after that it comes on our hand laptop, in the mobile. So right now we are having the internet in our mobile, right? Before that there is having the only in the PC, because we can using the Ethernet. Okay, so after that now the wireless communication, in the wireless communication our internet is in our hand. We can using in the mobile, even in watching this video through the internet. Okay, Now, internet is one component which has recently become the key ingredient of a quick and rapid lifestyle, be it for communication or exploration, connecting with people, or for official purpose. Internet has become the center hub for all. Okay, right now, now you can see in the lockdown, everyone is doing the work from home. How it is possible? If the internet is not there, it is impossible, right? So in the offices, everywhere now the internet, even the human, I will tell you right now, the current generation which is cannot live without the internet. So this is the very vast and the important subject that you are going to learn. Okay, so everyone is using the internet, you can download the video, but the concept is that, or we can find how this exactly happens, how the communication happens in between that. Okay, now the question is arises, what is the internet? It is a simple term. Internet is the access of human success. I will define it. It is in very simple language. It is a access of human success. So internet is a structured, organized system. Before we discuss how it works and its relationship in TCP/IP, we first give the brief history of the internet. We then define the concept of protocols and the standard and their relationships to each other. We discuss these standards are not developed by any specific organization, but rather through a consequence of users. So we discuss the mechanism through which these standards originated and matured. Also include in this introductory chapter is also the section of internet administrative groups. Okay, so these are the what internet. Now you can see this is the earth. Now the earth is totally interconnected with the different peoples which are using this internet. So suppose my one of the friend is in the US, and now I am talking with the video calls or talking with the video call with that person or my friend. How it is possible? It is not a magic. Okay, if in 30-40 years ago it is a simply magic, or even 50 years or 60 years back it was a magic, but right now it is not a magic. It can happen, and it is happened, right? So how it is? Okay, it is through the internet. And right now we have to see how the communication happens. Okay, so we all know we are the engineering students, and as an engineering student we must know how it happens. Okay, as a normal person, okay, you are just click on the YouTube, you just watch the video, you can see the video and you enjoyed it. Okay, so there is not any big thing in between that. But as an engineer person, or as an electronics and telecommunication engineer, you must know how the communication happens between the two persons. How my video or my live video can screen over the different location, or how I can see his live video at my home. Okay, so this is some questionable things, and everything we are going to solve in this topic or in the coming chapters in this subject. Okay, now where the origin of this internet, exactly how the internet come into the picture. Okay, so internet started as an experiment in the late 1960s by the Advanced Research Project Agency. In the short form, it is called as ARPA, and now it is called as a DARPA. Okay, so it is nothing but the one of the research project agency which is developed in 1960. They have done the experiment. Now what is the experiment? Now they experimented with the connection of computer networks by giving the grant of multiple universities and private companies to get them involved in the research. Okay, so they are going to do the research. So this Department of Defense, okay, this is nothing but the Department of Defense, was interested in finding a way to connect the computer together so that the researchers they funded could share their findings, thereby reducing cost and eliminating duplication of efforts. Okay, so the scientists want to share their information with each other, and they decided to connect their computers each other. Okay, so they have done the experiment. So 1967, at an Association for Computing Machinery, that is ACM meeting, ARPA presented its ideas for ARPANET, a small network of connected computers. The idea was that each host computer from the same manufacturer, it is not necessary,
would be attached to a specialized computer called as an interface message processor, that is IMP. The IMPs in terms of would be connected into each other. Okay, so this is how, this is the University of California at Los Angeles, the University of California at Santa Barbara, Stanford Research Institute, and the University of Utah were connected via the IMPs to the PROM network. So these are the different universities, they are connected with each other through this internet. So this is nothing but original, or we can say the Advanced Research Project Agency, where experimented and they have originated the internet. Now we are having, this is ARPANET, that I have already told you, the Advanced Research Project Agency network, and would be the first operation network they happen into the 1967 by connecting the different universities. Now that is nothing but ARPANET was developed under the US Department of Defense. It was developed to survive the nuclear attack. Okay, so this experiment is done to survive the nuclear attack. They are doing the research on that, and it was the first network to implement in the protocol suit TCP/IP. Okay, so it's nothing but transfer control protocol or internet protocol, where now this is TCP/IP protocol we are going to learn throughout the subject. Even in the last semester you learn in the computer network, that is TCP/IP protocols. Now this DoD divides the network into host and subnet. Okay, so this host, subnet, now this, the terms are new for you, but this you will get very familiar after some lectures. Now you can see this ARPANET. Suppose this is the internet, or you can see the IMP. IMP is nothing but what? Interface message procedures. Okay, so these are nothing but the specialized computers. Okay, these are connected. Now this host is nothing but, suppose this host is, means I am accessing the data from that host, or you can, some person can access the data from this internet. Now that I already told you, subnet is another type of network. So ARPANET consists of four main computers located. Okay, so they have located their computers at different cities. Okay, so that I already told you, that is University of California, that is Los Angeles, University of California, Santa Barbara, the Stanford Research Institute, and University of Utah. So in different, these computers are located at different locations. Now each of these computers serve as a host on the network, commonly today known as a server. Okay, so these four network or four computers having used as a server, and you can access the data from that servers. So you are the host and this is the server, so you can access whatever the data which is stored in this server, and you can access from there. Now there is a NSF, that is called as the National Science Foundation, which also one of the organization in 1980s started to make high capacity network for academic and engineering research. Now this NSF come into the picture, and it is used, or they are started to make high capacity networks academic for and research, engineering research. Now the NSF connected to its huge network of 5 supercomputers called NSF Net to ARPANET in 1986. Okay, so now you can see there is almost 20 years. In 1967 the ARPANET has started to do the evaluation, and now after the 20 years they now NSF Net to connected to the ARPANET in 1986. Now in 1990 internet working of ARPANET, NSF Net and other private networks resulted into internet. Now how the internet come? Okay, so in 1990 internet working of ARPANET, NSFNet and other private networks come together, and they have built as a network. Okay, so this is how the internet journey, and now I am going to see how the internet journey started. Now from here the internet has originated, we can say the birth of internet is there, and now from here how the things are running ahead from here. So now in 90s internet cost is rupees 25,000, now 9.5 kbps for 250 hours only. You can see rupee 25,000 for 9.6 kbps and how much hours? 250 hours only. So you can see how costly it was. Now in 20th century internet has become a more cheaper and faster ₹400, 1 Mbps unlimited internet for 28 days. Now you are getting the different offers from the different companies. Okay, so you can use 199, 1 GB per day. Okay, but you can see here, unlimited internet for 24 days. So in 20th century, early of 2000, 2001, 2002, there was the 400, so 1 Mbps is also very, I think the my generation and your generation also know that 1 Mbps you will get for 28 days, and it is also very costly. 400 rupees is also very costly in the nowadays. Okay, so 1 Mbps unlimited internet for 28 days. Now internet evolution from computer to smartphone. Now how evolution happens? Now first the internet is used for only PCs. Okay, then there will be a different service provider has now evolved the wireless communication. Through the wireless we can use the internet, and now in our hand we are come across the fastest internet, that is 4G and 5G in our hand by using the smartphones. Now in the 70s LAN network, and 1997 the wireless network has evolved, that is called nothing but the Wi-Fi, that is the wireless fidelity. Okay, so the Wi-Fi is nothing but Wi-Fi in evolved in 1997, and in 70s there is a LAN network. Okay, so LAN means you can connect your computers through cable. Okay, and this cable has been spread from one city to another city, so it is a very, we can say, the costly. That's why the internet is costly. Nowadays we can install one tower and we can send the data on particular frequencies, and we can get that data and we can see the videos, movies and everything on our phone. Now so that LAN concept is different and Wi-Fi is different. Now over the year internet for mobile phones is charged GPRS, that is 2G, 3G, 4G and 5G. Now we are heading towards the 5G. So over the internet, so in the mobile phone we are started from the 2G. Okay, now 3G, 4G and 5G. So you have the mobile communication subject, there is a very vast theory of this 2G, 3G, 4G and 5G. Okay, so now the fastest internet in the world, that is nothing but now the 5G. So internet host, internet user grow exponentially, top 1 billion. Now you can see in the picture, so there is a 3G, 384 kbps speed of that 3G, and for a you can say that 26 hours. Okay, for if you want to download something, so it required almost too much time. How long would it take to download the 2 hours long Guardian of the Galaxy? So Guardian of the Galaxy is one of the English movie. If you want to download that movie, so it takes 26 hours. So if there is a 3G network, it takes 26 hours. So what you would do while waiting? Okay, so there is too much waiting. So if you want to download, and it is also costly to, if you want to download the 2 hours movie by the 3G. So it has a 384 kbps speed. Now you can go for the 4G. You can see the 4G. So in the 4G there is a 100 mbps speed, and you can download 1 GB of data. So you can say the Guardian of the Galaxy, one of the my favorite movie that we are going to download. So it takes only 6 minutes. So you can see where is the 26 hours and where is the 6 minute. So you can see the what a big difference happen, or what a big evolution into the world of internet. And now there is very interesting, and the things are about to come, that is a 5G, that is a 10 Gbps of speed. Now it is in the few of the city they have started to do the installation of the 5G. So you can see, in the graph or in the picture, there is a 3.6 second is required to download the 2 hours of movie. Will you imagine that? How fast is the speed? So now on a one touch, or you can say one click, we are going to download the 2 GB or 3 GB of data or video or movie. Even the, you will see the online, you can see the video call HD in the quality of the HD without buffering. The buffering is the word it will not mention here. Okay, so it will, I think it is not in the dictionary of 5G what is a buffering. Okay, So this is what the way internet is evolved, and this is the history of internet. That is the first ARPANET is developed. After the ARPANET, there is NSFNet, and after combining the private networks and the NSFNet and ARPANET, they have developed the internet. And after there is the internet, there is a evolution, then the wireless network, wireless fidelity, we can say Wi-Fi come in the picture, and the evolution get happen. Okay, so now you must watch this first video. We are going to, this is our first topic, that is the evolution of the internet. So further we are going to learn the different topics. If you have any doubts, any suggestion, you can share into the comment. Okay, so I will request all my students, okay, kindly see all the full video. Okay, do not forward it, because this is important for you. Okay, so thank you very much.